Congratulations on all the work you've done so far. My question for you is, when you were doing season one and season two, were you afraid that people weren't going to like the message, or what were you most afraid of, that people wouldn't understand the message, or what was it?
Yeah, you know, I really was not thinking about people. I think the job of an artist is to reflect the times. And I felt, you know, Giants, I just wanted to be honest. And this show was more cathartic, and it was more about me telling my truth and creating something. I had spent a number of years working on other people's projects. You know, I was working on First, you know, I was working on a few short films, but I was directing and acting and producing, but I had not birthed anything. I had not put anything into the earth that was from my heart and, you know, my soul. And so when I was working on Giants, that was my focus. And, you know, of course, when you put things out, you hope people will like it. But I created the show from an honest place. I put it into the world and I let it go. And I'm grateful, you know, that people have enjoyed the show.
Good evening, my name is Georgie Hawkins, and I am a television producer and a proud rapper of Danny Blaine. So my question, being that I worked in TV for more than 10 years, what is the role of media when it comes to the state of mental health in this country?
You know, I may pass this on to even Nicole and Kerri as well. You guys see that. I mean, you run a media platform.
Again, going back to me running a platform, NicoleBitchy.com, that was more celebrity news and gossip, I think that weighed on my spirit for most of the bulk of the time I had the platform, because I'm like, I'm a media platform. These, you know, hundreds of thousands of women are logging into this site a day, multiple times a day. What am I feeding them? And even now, like, I refer to that site as a junk food, and the site I have now is a vitamin.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so, but it's, I mean, most media companies are so busy chasing page views and trying to get the story out first. They don't care about, like, how it's affecting their audience mentally, what they're, you know, checking the facts, how the stats, and a lot of sites race bait. You'll see black and white in the headlines some type of way. They just don't know how that subconsciously affects our audience, and I'm very aware of that, and that's why I changed my brand.
I just want to piggyback off of that from the celebrity standpoint. You don't know, you know, these blogs and those that are doing these write-ups that are so irresponsible, they can be so damaged. You don't know where a person is. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not just about what you're feeding the audience, it's also what you're doing to the creator, you know, the creatives, the entertainers, the athletes, the everyone here, the politicians even, not Trump, you do whatever to him, but you know, because he dishes it. But you know, there are a lot of undeserving people being attacked by just a headline. Like, you don't understand, like, some of the worst days of my life were just from a lie, you know, an attack on my character, and I happen to be an amazing person. Like, I do say that because I've done the work to become that, and all I ever wanted to be was just a great human being. But then I can't, thank you, and I'm grateful to finally have become who I dreamt of being. But anyway, from a celebrity standpoint, like, it's just, it's really, there's a lot of unfairness. There's a lot of, no one fact checks, no one cares how that affects your day, your family, your relationship, your career, your endorsements, your whatever, the list goes, your children, the list goes on and on and on and on. And so I think that I was so happy. I've just been a fan of Nicole Bitchy. Like, we hadn't even met each other, but I was DMing her years ago when it was still Nicole Bitchy. Sorry, Nicole Kane. But when it was still Nicole Bitchy, I was DMing her, like, even though it was still Nicole Bitchy, and you think of that as like junk food, fast food, there was an ism of responsibility that I could sense in her writings and in her write-ups. Her blog was just not like the others. And I appreciated that, and that's the way I literally DM'd her on Twitter and told her that, like, there's something different about you. And then when she finally made the transition, I DM'd her again. And, you know, I'm so proud that someone views themselves as a platform of responsibility. Because speaking of mental health, like, you don't know how that stuff affects us. You don't know how that affects us. You don't know what fragile state we may or may not be in. So,
you know what changed me? I went to a therapist. I think it was the year that, like, Freddie Gray, all the you know, black men were being killed. It was, we were doing suicide and murders on, but it was all types of stuff going on the blog. And I went to a therapist that year, and she told me I had secondhand, what is it, PTSD? And I'll tell you what, if I got secondhand, I know my audience is getting secondhand too. And I think that's what really just made me say, okay, I gotta switch my brand.
I'm glad you mentioned that, particularly as it relates to social media, what's happening, and the images and the videos that we're scrolling through over and over and over again. People don't recognize that that's traumatic. Right, that you're seeing people who look like you get murdered, and you're seeing lack of justice happen with that, you're seeing it happen over and over and over again. That stuff's not supposed to be in our psyche in that way, right? So it contributes, again, to a lot of depression and anxiety, and there's this kind of, I talked to my friend a lot about it, there's this kind of porn that's associated with how graphic this is, right? You have the news headlines, that kind of thing, that just kind of debate to get you into the article. But we're not supposed to be seeing that and kind of holding that stuff in our bodies, right? We hold trauma in the body, it's very physical. And again, if you're spending hours on social media and you're seeing videos every single time because they just come up automatically, imagine what that's doing to you. And then you're trying to switch gears and be at work, or switch gears and go to class. Like, you're still holding all that information with you while you're trying to function in the world, right? And it's trauma. That's what it is.
Yeah, I think they have to find a balance between reporting the news and, you know, being socially responsible. These are adults behind these blogs. There has to be balance. It's got to be someone. I hope that they all feel the way Nicole felt.
And it's in music.
As an elder of our communities.
It's in our music, too. Like, I know y'all be on a treadmill, listen to crunk music, but they be talking about something that's all in your head. You know, I got to the point where now, when I'm on a treadmill, I'm listening to audible books. Because I'm like, I can't listen to y'all talking about, like, you're about to beat up and this and that. Like, I